All right, let's get a little messy a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
Who was y'all least favorite guest that we've ever had on?
Yo, what up? It's your boy Larry Love, and welcome back, man, to a very, 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 very special edition of the Last Word podcast, man. It's the second season. What episode? Really don't give a damn. Who's on the casting couch?
It's your boy Chief Neef, y'all. What's up, man?
It's your boy Cartier J in the building.
Your boy Curly J in the building.
And as you guys can tell, and if you are real subscribers, not you other fake ass niggas who just hopped on the bandwagon recently, this is our 1 year anniversary video.
It's our birthday.
The podcast is officially 1 year old.
Damn. They grow so quick.
Bro, what? This year really fly, I ain't gonna lie.
It did.
Like, we went through a lot. Just to, I mean, if you look at episode one to now, come on, rags to, well, not rags to riches, but rags to medium, I don't know.
Medium class.
To medium class, middle class. Now, we really started off on like a little iPhone.
Not for real.
It was an iPhone. And then shouts out to, he's not even here today. He's supposed to be here, but he's out there hanging out with Beyonce and shit. But shouts out to Jay Next Door.
Not for real.
Yo, Jared, real
life. Should have been on, he should have really had something.
He should have been here.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, but Jay Next Door helped us a little bit. We're here filming now. We just keep growing and prospering. I'm happy about that.
Shout out to, like he said, shout out to all the day one supporters too, man. Like a lot of people stuck it through with us. Cause I ain't gonna lie, the beginning picture, I didn't see no vision to where we are now. So I just appreciate all that love. And we kind of have a special episode for y'all. So we're gonna really do like talk about a few things, like just to reflect on the past year. And we're going to get into a little segment after that where we answer questions that a lot of people have asked us that want to know about the podcast. So,
Now, go ahead.
Go ahead, bro.
Let's kick it off with favorite moments. I got a couple.
Huh. One of your favorite moments.
Favorite moments.
Damn. It's on camera, right? Or like, podcast as a group.
Oh, it doesn't have to be on camera. I think that one of my favorite moments was in the beginning when we really, it was the strip club one with the wigs that we really I think that was my favorite moment just because we really, I'm sorry, we clickbait the fuck out of y'all. Y'all would have thought we was actually in Magic City. We was literally in the parking lot eating wings in the Magic City.
And we weren't even eating Magic City wings.
It was American Deli. You see it on the cup too. Hey, yo.
And shout out to Jerry. He helped us out with that intro too that made it look like
that was his first episode too.
First episode with us. That was the first time we met Jared. Yo, we've known Jared for a year.
But that was the second episode. The first one was on the iPhone.
No, the first episode with Jared.
Yeah.
Oh, and that's another thing we can talk about. Our first, we really filmed multiple videos with that iPhone, but they were all shitty. And then we got Jared. So we really have a bunch of deleted scrap videos.
I still got them videos.
We have 5 unreleased videos, and one of them, we're like I ain't gonna lie, some of them we just said some cancelable ass shit. Like, you cannot put that all on the internet type shit. So yeah, maybe one day down the line when we have a
Patreon
or OnlyFans, where the hell we got, y'all can see that and go ahead cancel us. But
I think my favorite moment though, it had to be like when that girl Dayla was on and she was talking about crystals. And I'm sorry, that's such bullshit, bro.
Bro. Oh my god.
She
asked
me, like, she's like, what's your birth chart? What's all that? I'm like, look it, bitch, I'm here. I don't really like the whole crystal. She was like, this crystal, it protects you and you can manifest some great shit, but can't nobody touch it. But then she letting Jalen rub all over it. So I'm like, is the magic worn off?
She said she's going to cleanse it.
Come on, bro.
Hey, yeah,
at the end of the day,
with the sage,
we respect everybody. You know,
like if I'm in a shootout, you want me to put up a crystal?
Oh shit!
No.
I'd say my favorite moment. Okay, I'll say one off camera, one on camera. One off camera was when we went to Juicy Crab. That was my first time ever going to Juicy Crab.
That is such a fat ass answer.
It was good.
We went to Juicy Crab.
That was a good vibe too. We saw some nice faces over there.
I think that's the only time we ever like just us four on some kick it shit.
Cause it's always like, it's always one person missing. It's always one person missing. It's never always all four of us unless we film.
Yeah, it's also not easy though. We all work. We all have
shit,
We all have shit to do, man. Like, and we also all don't live in Atlanta. So
Okay, so what's your favorite on camera?
My favorite on camera was probably, I really did like that Extreme Would You Rather episode that we did.
That video did good.
Yeah, like, that I was like, really good. I literally, till this day, like, I still die laughing watching that episode. Mm-hmm. Like, I enjoyed that a lot. Plus, the Would You Rather episodes are just so, I'm someone that likes to think about sharing like shit like that. So when we talk about it on the camera,
yeah,
I like it a lot.
So, all right, so let's just get to that question then. What's your favorite episode? I have a few. I ain't gonna lie.
Mine had to be the Lori Harvey where Nefe was like talking about
him. I opened up the door for him and shit.
That's my favorite episode, bro.
I had a few. Okay, so if one that I like that is very underlooked in my opinion is the Wealthiest Podcast one. I like that one because I feel like we always have kind of people on that have like a brand or just talk about fuck shit. But I kind of like to be educated a little bit. And I feel like that was kind of a different type of guest for us. I really like the Childhood Mukbang one. That one to this day kind of has me laugh.
The damn food.
The Childhood Mukbang one was one of my favorites too. Yeah. And the mental health one that we did with Awesome.
That's
I
what I was going to say, bro.
I like that one a lot
Awesome,
too.
Awesome's episode is actually like, when it came to just guest chemistry, was the most dynamic. Like it felt natural.
We've had chemistry with Awesome though since like day one.
Freshman year.
So like Piedmont Central freshman year. So if you know about Piedmont Central, then you know.
That was a good episode too, talking about Piedmont Central.
Bro, wait.
Throwback. That probably was my favorite though. Cause we talked about all the memories and shit we used to have and I missed that stripper pole. God, I really do, man.
You wanna know what else I actually liked a lot? Our Lil Wayne versus Jay-Z, wasn't
that
it?
That was good.
Yeah. I liked that video a lot. And I feel like that was kind of like the...
That's technically our first kind of viral.
Viral video, yeah. That one I liked a lot.
I really messed with it, though.
Even when we filmed that video, I felt like it was just great, like the video, even before seeing it go on YouTube or go on Spotify and Apple. All
right, let's get a little messy a little bit. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. Who was y'all least favorite guest that we've ever had on?
I don't want to answer first.
I'd probably say Ari.
Oh, shit.
That was me. But that's actually a valid answer. It's a valid. Ari, I love you, but that was a valid answer.
It was it was last minute.
It was very last minute, like, but she came through.
She wasn't even supposed to be on
that
episode.
Yeah.
We're trying to get Dion on.
She sat down. She did her job, though.
Yeah.
I can't Ari.
She fulfilled her role.
Yeah.
All right, let's get real, though. Really, Ari.
I don't even know he's going to say names, but fuck it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Wait, should we be saying? I don't think we should be saying names.
Fuck it. Really,
how are we going to say if we don't
say it? It's no hate. It's just the least favorite.
Yeah.
Like everybody that we had on the podcast, we've actually valued and appreciated that they even came on.
Well, I want to start off like this because I'm going to say the name. We do appreciate everybody who came on the podcast and helped us out or whatever. We thank y'all for that, but now let's get really into the name because we got to start off cool. Like, I don't want to just go
I just said that. Go ahead.
Okay. All right, well, we fuck with y'all, but go ahead. Say who your least favorite.
He's going to say yours.
Fuck it. Sabrina and Tiffany.
Really?
Wow. Yeah, I really was not feeling that video. Everybody loved that video, but I did it.
I liked it.
I know why.
Now, the video concept, the whole Valentine's Day, it made sense, but I could see why.
Yeah, it was
you don't think they gave good energy?
They weren't the energy I was looking for that video, if that makes any sense.
They was chill. Tiffany, you got a little bit of laugh. Come on.
Oh, shit. Mine would probably have to be
Shauna,
bro.
Shauna?
I agree, because
it was not my favorite, but it wasn't the worst.
Over Tiffany and Sabria? Ugh.
No, Tiffany, Sabria, Bree, Shauna. Beat Shauna, I mean.
Wait.
Yeah, they beat Shauna, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I know. We said Bryce. I did not like the Bryce episode at all.
Yeah, that was our first video, like first guest video.
It was our first guest one, and I think it was just the fact of we were trying to figure out the dynamic of how to interact with guests on the podcast. Mm-hmm. And I say I wasn't even a part of the episode.
That's
so
true.
And even like y'all didn't see the episode they recorded after that without me, but it felt like, I don't know, the dynamic was weird. If there's not all four of us on the camera,
I feel like something was missing.
Yeah, like it just the energy wasn't,
and then the audio wasn't good at all too.
Yeah.
So.
There's a whole lot of
fucked up shit.
Who is your favorite guest?
Favorite guest?
Yeah, see y'all top three.
Top three guests?
Favorite
guest. Oh, thank God he gave us a three.
No, Awesome was my favorite guest.
I was going to say Awesome is up there.
Awesome's on there.
I was saying
Jerry, because he's been on multiple episodes.
He wasn't I love Jerry, but he wasn't my favorite guest.
Nah.
Because remember the album?
The album.
The one with Summer Walker that we held up the... Like, that was a good episode.
It was.
And
but favorite. And he had this song.
I don't know if I feel like Jared need to do another video. I keep saying that.
No, Jared, you're gonna see this anyways. You're gonna do another video.
But would I say he's in my top three? Probably not. I like Palmer. Palmer gave good energy.
Oh shit, Palmer.
I forgot about Palmer.
And that's why I wouldn't say top three.
Okay, I say Awesome, Palmer, and the 1% podcast.
1% set in my top three for sure.
That's why, honestly, they're probably my top.
Because that episode was so good, and people really did not even look at that episode.
I really liked, first of all, I liked when they came out, like we were talking, we had good energy before filming, so that's why. And then also, I feel like they did a good job with breaking down everything that we had to ask. Sometimes guests don't really, they're kind of annoying with that, I'm not going
to. They're a little shallow on their explanation. Yeah, a little shallow about that. Okay, I see what y'all saying, but I still put, okay, this is an order. It's Awesome, 1%, and I'd say, I'd just say Jared just because the fact of, bruh, every time, like, literally, like, whenever we filmed, it's literally us, it's us five, like, us five as in including Jared, so it just felt like another cool sit down. I wasn't worried about anything because literally the fact of I know that nigga, you see what I'm saying?
Uh-huh. Ooh.
Okay, this is my top. Oh, you want to do your top?
No, go ahead.
Okay, my top three, 1%.
I got to look on our page.
I'm going to count Chanel and Fresh Dew as one.
Oh,
no. Oh, yeah, yeah.
And then I'm going to put.
Yeah, we got a lot of videos. I couldn't even scroll through.
I put Tiffany and Sabria.
Tiffany and Sabria.
We got top three?
Yeah.
Okay. If I had one video to redo, I would redo them with this setup and these mics. Because I feel like the mics was off, kind of, and they didn't really give us anything. But I feel like now that they know what to do, it'd be a little better.
I think that's the thing, though, because everybody wants to come on the podcast, but no one really realizes that when these lights and, like, cameras are on you, like, people kind of come more reserved and shit. And I feel like, if like you just said, if they had that experience or they had that, and I know how the vibe is, then it would have probably been a better episode. But that's just everybody, though.
Yeah,
that was even us, because those five episodes that we deleted, like the first one, man, I was nervous as hell. I didn't even talk for real.
I say my top three, Awesome. I'm gonna hit y'all with a sleeper. I'm gonna say Awesome. Okay, I love you, Palmer, but no disrespect, I gotta kick out Palmer. The 1% girl's number two, and I gotta say the softball episode was my third one.
Oh, that was a good one.
The softball episode I really like, cause Kayami and Emaya,
they're cool as fuck.
I like talking about sports in the NCAA.
I feel like we the same. I feel like the audio I ain't fuck with. That's probably.
But there's a lot of funny moments in that one.
Yeah. You remember they took down that TikTok?
They took that. Wait, which one?
That one, the one TikTok that you had, Dave, where it's like, oh, you can't do it, like, because they're sharing a room. You're like, oh, you can't.
That was going viral.
It was going viral. You remember, and they took it down?
Yeah, you can't even beat your dick when your roommate's in the room.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, let's talk about that shit real quick. TikTok hates on us.
That's what I was actually. Okay, so can we get into that? I was about to say, what was the hardest part about like the TikTok? Like, I feel like an obstacle that we had to overcome. I feel like TikTok was the biggest one. We were shadow banned like fuck y'all. Like, it was crazy.
TikTok pick and choose when to do that shit though.
Yeah.
Cause it's like me or a girl could be half naked on TikTok. They won't say nothing. But as soon as we cussing on TikTok, oh, violation.
We're not even the only ones that cuss on TikTok. That's my biggest problem is the fact of if you watch our content, like, that's why we started bleeping out cuss words. If y'all didn't realize that, we bleep out cuss words or certain things just because the fact of in our original account, because we're on our second one, we literally kept on like, getting shit taken down or we're shadow banned and we're getting seven. What a few
it
of
was
our
like
used
seven
to get two views.
Yes.
The two views was me and Josh.
That's very depressing.
It was so annoying, yo.
Nigga, that should be blowing me, bro.
And it was one of those things where it's like we honestly needed it too. Cause TikTok is the way you get pushed nowadays.
Hell yeah.
Like every content creator needs to be on TikTok. Like that's the way to
And our
content.
Older clips are better than our newest shit too.
Way better.
That's the problem, because our old account has so many old good ass clips. And you could try and repost them. But sometimes it just doesn't.
Or how about this? We were reposting it on our new account and that shit was going viral. Exactly. Ain't that crazy?
Yeah.
Man. Yeah, TikTok, they was playing with us.
I also want to say something real quick. When it comes to TikTok, I don't know where it is. But for some reason, it loves this nigga. Because we'll right? At first, it was Larry was in charge of TikTok.
I love TikTok.
He was posting TikToks. We ain't got no push. Then Josh, little push. I tried for maybe like when this nigga was off doing whatever the hell, nothing. This nigga, that's how we got our viral clips.
Bro, like, I don't know. And he'll tell, okay, this is the thing. He'll be like, okay, dude, this hashtag at this time.
I literally tell them everything step by step.
I think, I don't know what happened. I don't know. Maybe you were sick or some shit. I don't know. Something happened.
I was out of town.
I had filled in and I literally did exactly what he told me to
the T, bro.
To the T. And that shit didn't do nothing. And I was just like, fuck this shit. We'll wait till you get back.
That like, shit weird like that.
Yeah. Man, some things just, I don't know.
All right, let's get into some real, like, behind-the-scenes stuff. Mm-hmm. Have any of us ever fucked up so bad that we wanted to fire somebody off the podcast?
Yes.
I could have got fired for a couple shit.
I think there was two people, for sure. Because
I walked in front of a shoot. I took my dick out. Oh, no, I'm just playing. I ain't never. I walked in front of a shoot, did the whole John Cena thing, and fucked up Nia's video along with her. And then
Oh shit.
Hey man, I'm drunk. You can't.
I'm drunk.
And then on another episode, so we did like a whole episode. Energy was good, video was good, Jared was out of town. And then like the whole episode was in slow-mo. So imagine 30 to 40 minute episode in slow-mo.
That shit was so bad.
When I tell you, I can't remember what episode that was, but that was a good one.
It was a good one.
Great episode.
Like we were so mad. We were so mad.
What was it? There was another episode.
I'll say I wanted to fire Jared. He had fucked up one time with the interface.
It was a great video. It was such a great. And sometimes I feel like when like Jared fucks up, he's trying his best not to like make it big. He's like, oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, the video's fucked. Like, he's just so like nonchalant about it. Yeah, the video's fucked.
That nigga funny as
hell. Yeah, he'd be like, the video's fucked.
That's all I love, though. That's all I love.
I think those are the two. I ain't gonna lie. Those are the top two.
Okay, I'd say this.
It's when you go
not fired, but. Like say someone really annoyed you, man, at the beginning, it's like in Westmore, it doesn't happen now, but sometimes getting this nigga up to shoot, goodness gracious, you be feeling bad. Like I'd be like, hey Jalen, get up. He be like, what? You make me feel bad. Like I'm not supposed to wait this nigga up.
Okay, but now I hate to say it, Josh.
Oh, I'm about to get the hint to it.
Yeah, Josh, it's you now. Wait, you're the issue now.
Wait, getting waking up?
No, you're never on time.
Nigga,
you're always late.
This nigga Josh is doing and everything else but
how about
here.
He still is in the same building as us, but you're late. How are you later than Larry, who has to drive, get checked in, and everything?
Larry got his food, his little American
deal. Hold on. I got an excuse for myself. I used to get off at 10. Y'all used to make the things at 10, and they expect me to be there at 10 when I got off work at 10. And now you work at Target, or you used to work at Target, so you know how it is getting off at 10.
Nah, facts. You got to sneak out. We used to sneak out all the time. Fuck Target. Damn. Shout out to them anyway.
It ain't fuck Target. Target, we love you. Sponsor us.
I still shop there.
Yeah, I still shop there.
You shop at Target?
Yeah.
That's some weird ass niggas.
Weird?
Weird.
Target is like the bougie Walmart. It's like Publix.
It's like Publix. I was about to say,
why are you going to bougie Walmart?
Why not?
I'm going to Walmart.
Because that's where shopping is a pleasure.
We're shopping. Okay.
And then, too, you see a lot of bad women in Target, too.
You do. No
like,
care.
It'll be like in the middle of the day, you'll see the most beautiful. I'm like, you ain't got no man? Like that shit will be crazy.
And honestly, Target is calming. Like it's something calming about Target.
I used to walk in and smell popcorn. I don't do that shit now. I don't think they make popcorn no more.
They got Starbucks now. All of them are broken now.
Like y'all realize that when we were kids, they used to have the popcorn and the slushies
and the Pizza Hut.
Yeah.
You just said like it'd be bad women in Target. Has there ever been a guest that y'all invited that you invited or wanted to invite just because of
sexual interest?
Right.
Not a sexual interest, but I kind of used to have a thing for. I would say Sabria. And I'm drunk, so I won't remember none of this shit. No, I'm lying. Was it two?
I have.
I think it was another. I think we're gonna name names.
This episode.
I'm not naming names. I'm not naming names for this. I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna be real.
But I would say your conversation. I actually liked y'all's thing on the episode because we had a lot of the same views. So I would say that. But I would say Sabria and Tiff more, but mainly Sabria.
I got my two.
I think I wanted to invite a girl, but it was like she didn't really. She didn't really do anything for the podcast. She just wanted to like come and sit in.
We haven't done the episode yet. But the bad one, like the one with the
OnlyFans?
No, the bad ones. The bad the bougie episode. Have you ever done it yet?
You ain't gonna say no names, but when that episode come out, y'all gonna know.
But am I attracted to them? I feel like I'm not attracted to them.
Yeah, you're tweaking.
I'm not attracted to them.
Y'all shit malfunctioning. Them girls are bad.
They're bad, but I'm not. Sweet. Yeah, they're beautiful. I'm not. I wouldn't say I'm attracted to them.
You say they're beautiful, then you're attracted to them.
But I don't think they look better than an old girl, though. That's just my opinion, though. But I'm biased. I like dark skinned girls. So the darker the girl, the more beautiful I think she is. Just technically.
Yeah, but Laura made you the opposite because you're light as fuck.
But you know, for real. Like light-skinned people and light-skinned people like dark-skinned people. Okay. So it's weird.
I'd say mine was, I mean, Kayami. Kayami was fine as fuck.
For real, she is.
But like I also fuck with the energy that she brought to the pod too. She's a cool person. Other person. Yeah. Kayami.
That's it.
She's I'm be 100. Naya was one, but the one who I like afterwards was definitely Alexa from the 1%.
Oh my god,
Alexa!
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Take him away!
Yeah,
there you go, right there. Right, check. Hey, right,
hey, yo,
officer,
that shit's
arrest that man.
Hey, bro,
lock his ass.
She is fine. No, she is fine.
She is. Stop.
She's
it.
Pretty.
We had some fine ass people on this podcast.
No, for real.
Respect to our queens, man.
No, for real. Respect to y'all.
Should we get a white girl on here soon?
Yes.
I want to talk to y'all about that.
But I don't know no white people.
So we've had a very.
I do. We'll
wait. You guys say yours. You ain't slick.
That's facts. Wait, who I was attracted to?
Nigga, please.
Stop it.
I know. He is such a
I literally had the people in my head for this.
I did say Chanel before the episode. I did say that.
No, but okay.
And she got a nice name. I like that Chanel.
That's it.
Yeah.
Let me stop naming. I'm about to start shooting it.
Nah, I would say that.
I was about to say like Sabrina wanted them.
Nah.
Okay.
But I did mess with one.
Like you on a date, right?
Ooh, oh yeah.
One of the softball. The other softball girl.
Nigga, that's a 50%.
Well, you gonna figure it out then.
Hey, yo.
Yo.
It's going to be an interesting episode. I love the energy, bro. I love the energy.
Yeah, so, but I do want a white girl. I think we just got to go to Whole Foods one day and leave some bread out there and just lay a trap for them. Some wheat bread.
I will say this, though. When it comes to the podcast, we had a lot of diverse guests, but I think I said this to y'all the other day. We got to go into other races, bro. Like, and we also got to go into, tap into the
different communities. LGBT.
We tried to get one for 5 months, but it was like y'all kept slamming the door in our face.
Not one. We're trying to get a person.
No, but
he said we trying to get one. That's nuts. But I mean, shit.
Did I say something? I'm sorry.
Oh my fucking god!
Wait, what happened?
It's gonna be interesting, bro.
But no, we was okay. First of all, let's pause. We are an ally for the LGBT. TQ.
Yeah, you making hella hard. Yeah.
No, I'm just trying to make sure I get every letter correct. Yeah, but the LGBTQ plus community, and we actually really want to have one on the podcast so we can. I fucking hate this podcast, man. But we need to have one of y'all on the podcast so we can really, really like have a conversation. Because honestly, I do want to open up more doors and letting it be accepted, like everybody as a community.
You don't see guys our age, like at all.
Yeah.
Talking.
I need somebody to break that shit down to me how it go. Cause I was literally having a conversation with this dude in like Zaxby's the other day, and he was looking at and he had a wristband. So I was like, I don't give a fuck. I asked him, I was like, so hey man, that pride thing, where did pride come from? How does that work? And he literally gave me the whole rundown. The cool little white dude, and I was like, appreciate that. And he gave me the whole rundown. He tried to get my number, but I was like, no, I don't do that. But yeah, so that was pretty cool though.
And we need some white people on this podcast. We need some Hispanic people on this podcast, some Asian people on this podcast, some Indian people on it. Like, we showing the whole globe, man. We got to be diverse.
I do want to get, really get a homeless person on the podcast though. But we got to get rid of the seat right after.
No, I did say I want to get somebody else fresh out of jail though.
I do too. That'd be a great episode.
Like, fresh out of prison?
Yeah.
Like, nigga, how your asshole feel?
Oh my
God. God, I can't say that.
Next question, bro.
What was he at? Stupid idea. Okay, what are stupid ideas that someone he could die.
It was a lot of stupid ideas, I would say.
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna be 100. Fuck it. I ain't fuck with the boot prank shit. I thought it was a stupid idea for a pop.
The boot man one. I want us to do pranks and stuff, and they was like, no, we're not doing pranks.
Yeah, I thought that was a dumbass idea.
No, but my idea was I literally wanted to like go to either lofts or like I either wanted to go to like lofts or really go to like 565 Hank or Aspen, boot somebody's car and wait for them to see and get their reaction over.
They gonna shoot you, bro.
No, they won't.
What?
Yo, let's get a shot.
We wanted to fight people that boot our cars. I'm not doing that shit.
But anytime I done got booted, though, I done been in the wrong, so I can't say.
A dumb idea. Probably.
Oh, I got
one. Yeah, I got mine. Shit, the t-shirt machine. That shit was dumb as hell.
I like it.
Hey, bro, we could buy, we know so many designers. Like, we got designer right. I mean, y'all gonna figure that shit out later. Yeah. But we got designer work cooking a little something up for the crew, and I know that shit's way cheaper than the whole t-shirt this machine.
That's true.
I think that's a dumb idea.
I can't think. I feel like we don't have a lot of dumbass ideas given by other people. But I just can't name none of them.
Yeah.
Hell yes. Goodness.
But people be giving us suggestions, and I just be like, next.
Also, too, when I see you, I'm so tired of this line. Everybody who has a podcast, you can relate. Yo, if I see you and I say, oh, yeah, I have a podcast or whatever. Oh, can I come on the podcast? No. Like, I'm tired of, like, no, but it's just, no, when I, okay, hear me out.
No, you got to be like that.
No, like, sometimes, honestly, it's just like, I feel like that's what they use just to talk. Like, it kind of gets kind of.
Let me expand on that, though, because. What I say is, right, when someone says, can I come on a podcast, I always ask them,
what do they have to offer? Yeah.
90% of the time, niggas want to shit on girls or girls want to shit on niggas. There's literally nothing else of substance that people ever offer. Mm-hmm. Like, that's why, like, when y'all see the guests that we have, mm-hmm. we usually reach out to them because we see something that, okay, they're a genuine person and they have an actual an actual topic or something to actually discuss that brings something good to the podcast. You gotta think about it. It's a business. We're trying to get up. So we're not just gonna put any random nigga just to shit on girls for fucking 20 minutes. That's a waste of our time.
Yeah.
So shit like that. Like we have to be smart with our choices.
And that shit getting old too, the whole niggas ain't shit. Women ain't. I don't want to say the B word because we trying to cut it out. But niggas ain't shit.
Women ain't shit.
Like that shit is getting.
Everybody ain't shit. How about that?
Yeah, everybody ain't shit.
Everybody ain't shit. That's getting old.
Bro.
That should be blowing.
Find something else. Say your mom ain't shit. Find something else.
Your grammy ain't shit. All right. So I kind of want to get though into something to help out people who are trying to be like us, who are trying to start up a podcast. Like, what are some tips that y'all would give somebody who's trying to build up a podcast?
Get a job.
Be consistent.
No, get a fucking job.
If you think you could do a podcast, well, no, people can do it on a cheaper level. But if y'all want to be on our level, I'm not trying to gloat. You need a damn job because I was unemployed and my shit was on E a lot. My car got declined the other day. Like, hey, but I start work on Monday though, so I'm straight. But like, y'all, this shit ain't cheap. It's a lot. All this equipment, you got mics, mic stands, mm-hmm. you got cameras, you got an SD audio interface, SD cards, lighting, signs if you want. Shit.
And more importantly, time. Time is more valuable than all that Come shit. You on, gotta man. Put in time. You actually gotta sit down and figure this shit out.
Yeah.
You got to. And you got to get a group of motherfuckers around you that were willing to sit with you and figure this shit out. Because
that's the fact.
You know, you would drive yourself crazy. Like, what does this do? What does that do? What does this do? What does that do? And you would just go fucking blind.
One tip.
I say do your research. Like, one thing is that we can tell the story about the audio interface story. We literally went to some random ass record store, picked
Audio
up the
Lab. Fuck you.
Audio Lab. It's dead ass. In little 5 points, it's dead ass. Like, we have beef. But literally, we went in there, picked. Beef.
No, but we really should have beef. That was our fuck up. That nigga said no refund. No, we should have walked out right there.
Went in there, got a fucked up, what's it called, audio interface, and
that bitch from 1983.
Yes, and that shit was expensive as fuck. It was like how much per person?
That shit was like
it was 300 in total. So it was probably like I don't know, divide that by four.
I don't know. It was a lot, but that I would say is. But also too, I kind of did say with every fuck
75.
Up, you're gonna. We love a mathematician, but
hey, I used to sell dope.
with every fuck up, you're going to learn though something new. So that's why I would say now we have a great audio interface. Our audio is better. Another thing I would say is just start. Like, that's another thing. I always, my favorite quote right now is "Do it scared," because we always kind of give ourselves a pushback. We're like, "Oh, what? How are they gonna think we look? Our quality is not good. Yeah. I don't have enough money for that camera. Just do it." And once you start doing it, the shit just starts coming together. It's like a puzzle. You're just gonna figure out the pieces. So that's another good tip of mine, I would say.
That's what my uncle told me.
Yeah, because even now, like, there's never gonna be a perfect product. Like, even now, our episodes aren't even perfect. No. Y'all can literally see that shit, hear it. But you just gotta roll with the punches and you're gonna learn, like you said, you're gonna learn as you go.
Yeah.
Everything's a lesson.
No, what everything is a lesson.
Yeah.
What you got?
Shit, I don't know. I was gonna say keep a job, bro. This shit is expensive.
And I ain't got
I'll say I got another thing.
And find a balance too. Yeah. Like, find a balance. I know everybody wanna have their social life, everybody wanna have, I don't know, some of y'all in college. Find a balance, sit the fuck down. Just one day, you ain't got nothing to do. Just sit down, map it out, and get it together. That's all I got to say.
Yeah.
I'd say another piece of advice real quick. Find people that are passionate about this shit. Because everybody can say they're going to start it, and then y'all going to start it for maybe an episode or two, and then no one's really pushing for real. Like, even us, we have our own slumps, man. Like, we're normal. But at the same time, though, we all know at the end of the day that we're all going to show for the podcast. We're actually going to put energy towards the podcast. We're passionate about this shit.
There was a few podcasts out there that we all started at the same time, or they started after us or before us.
You know, I named them, but the episode got deleted. You think this one going to delete it if I name them?
Don't name them.
Why can't I name them?
Don't name them. It's not needed.
Dad, no, you always do this to me.
There's no need.
But yeah, it was a few of them out there that...
Breakfast Club.
they're not here anymore.
Put their ass out of business.
Now we put Breakfast Club out of business.
I love you, Breakfast Club. But I mean, yeah, we outlive some of them. But you know, it is what it is.
Yeah.
On to the next, bro. You just gotta keep on grinding. But
I think we should get into our goals.
Yeah.
Okay.
Goals for year two.
Start getting monetized.
I was about to say, get some fucking money. I want to get paid off this shit. I'm tired of not getting paid. I'm tired of working like a slave. I tire myself. Like, damn.
I would say we start getting monetized. Start working on, I know it's a long way, but start working on like having to get noticed. Because when we go out in public, I feel like that was our unofficial first big thing that felt good. So when we go out in public, we get recognized for this shit. And people be like, hey, are you from Last Word Podcast? So to me, that feels good. I know that everybody else, it probably feels good. So that was like our unofficial first kind of goal. It was my goal anyway. And I guess goal for year two is like for like companies and other like YouTube and stuff to start noticing us. I guess get a bigger following. Yeah, sponsorships and shit like that.
I say I have two goals. I have, well, one of like this, this one of the goals is, and we did well at the recent, when Bryson Tiller had that event, we just network more. Like, I feel like us as a podcast, you know, everybody wants to start certain things or certain businesses when everybody has that confidence to actually go promote their brand no matter where the hell it is in those big settings. So I just want us for year two, to actually really be open and be confident in our shit and really express it to everybody, because you never know who's listening. You never know who you can encounter. And every opportunity that you have outside is another opportunity to promote your brand, get your shit up. And I really think that if we really utilize that shit in year two, y'all gonna see us at a whole nother level. Y'all gonna see us in the studio. Like, I really believe that we can really tap into that. And my second goal for us is just to be better with communication. And I think we all lack in this, into where we all have our days or our moments to where, you know, little moody, or we're just not feeling it and we don't communicate that with each other, and then it's just a whole day of the chat is kind of empty, little replies, this and the third. I think we all got to tap in on that and just, yeah, there's gonna be hard days, it's gonna be days that we don't want to do that shit, but at the same time, for where we want to be at, we got to push through. The people that are great in this industry or just any industry in general, they push through those days that they don't want to do shit, because that's what separates the greats from the regulars. So I think we got to tap in
the
on that
1%ers.
As well.
Yeah. We finna put Drink Champs out of business too. I just want to put that out there.
My goal would be to get a studio.
That's a studio and employees.
Employees?
Yeah, I need like two people.
You gotta pay them niggas.
I know.
It would be like, when he says employees, he means editor and someone that runs the studio.
An editor and audio. Those are the two people we need. We can always just cut on some damn lights ourselves, but I want somebody to always be able to set up the audio for us and be able to just edit our videos for us. That's it.
Oh, hell yeah, because I'm tired of these. Hey, man, since day one, a nigga's not rested from editing. Mm-hmm. That shit is taxing, but fuck it. You gotta do what you gotta do.
Fucking sound checks. I'm tired of saying that shit.
Oh, my God. Sound check is fucking annoying,
y'all. Yeah.
And the fact that y'all, we literally do a sound check, we straight, listen to the video, that audio's ass.
Yeah.
Every fucking time. But I mean, yeah, I think.
We got some good stuff coming for y'all for year two, bro.
Yeah.
Some good guests. That's going to be my biggest thing. I love having guests.
Like, I feel like our guests have been elevating this season.
Yeah, they have been.
They've been great this season.
I think, my last goal. I keep on thinking of this. I want us to execute what we say. I feel like for this month of October, we've had a lot of big ideas. And we've had a lot of big ideas throughout the whole life of the podcast, but I feel like we haven't always executed or we've never always written down our ideas. Like, we'll say something, say, oh, yeah, that's good. Then forget about that shit like a week later. You know what I'm saying? I feel like this year, too, I'm telling y'all, I feel like year one was really just learning, like learning, testing shit out, blah, blah, blah. But year two, we really just got to be tapped in on our stuff. And, I mean, Lord knows where we're going to take us. You know what I'm saying? The sky's the limit.
I want a big sponsorship, too.
From who?
Manscaped.
Yeah.
I feel like we all love Manscaped. I've been wanting a Manscaped sponsorship. Manscaped sponsors, please. We bet. Manscaped.
I know all my big sponsorships I want, nigga. I want Manscaped. I want
Uber.
PSA, I want Chipotle. I want Uber. I want shit. P-Hub if possible. Fucking. Whoa. Nigga.
I want Google fans. Maps. Google Maps is hard. Or Apple Maps or whatever. I think Google Maps would be the
sponsor. Apple? Does Apple even sponsor people?
I don't think so.
If Apple sponsored us?
Or Beats.
Come on.
Oh, Beats?
Beats by Beats.
But I don't use Beats. I'm a JBL guy. Because Beats, I feel like Beats are very good, though. But I feel like Beats are kind of fragile. JBL's a little louder.
Yeah, use them Beats to be sponsored.
I was about to say, for the right price, I'm a Beats fan.
I'm
going
to throw my Beats by Dre.
AirPods. See, I don't know. I feel like I can say that, though. But I feel like if I sponsor somebody, I really want to be something I use on an everyday thing. Not just like, just because y'all give me some money, or I'm going to just tell
people. Yeah, I feel like that's where a lot of niggas fuck up, too. Like, at the house, let's just say they're sponsored by Beats, but they at the house with some AirPods. Next thing you know, paparazzi come by. Oh, I saw LeBron with the AirPods in his ear. Now this nigga done lost his deal.
And that's the
just
biggest,
because he don't like it.
I think Chanel and Fresh Jewel talked about it, how some people take brand deals that are kind of out of their interest or out of their niche in a way. And that's certain things that I think that's probably a wrong, like you said, it's a bad thing to do because you can also fuck up your sponsorship. So just be genuine about your shit. And you already know how we rock. What we rock with, and of course Manscaped, all of us are men. Well, gotta keep our shit, you know what I'm saying, scaped, nice and clean for these ladies.
I feel like right now, the level we're at, we'll sponsor some pantyhose if the price is right. We just gotta get in the door.
That's what I'm like, y'all talking like this, but right now, we got an email right now talking about a legit sponsorship. I don't give a fuck what it is. It could be a damn wig brand. I'll wear that lace front. Shit.
I don't know, like, you know,
sponsored
how
by hair by key or some shit.
You know how niggas are getting the that's fucked up. You know how niggas are getting like the lace dreads or whatever? If they want to sponsor us, I'd do that shit.
Like Jimmy Butler, get the extensions or some shit.
Oh yeah, he looks so stupid.
I get a bald man to be like sponsored by a toupee or some shit on this damn couch. Shit.
Sponsored by got to be.
Yeah.
Sponsored by wax, nigga. Fuck it.
Wax? Ooh, yeah. I don't know. I can't do no wax.
I need my bills paid.
I thought he was gonna say something. you what? I would say that. So right now, hey, if you got some cocaine, we won't do it, but we'll sponsor it. I tell everybody else to do it. Take a bump here and there. Last word says it's okay.
Also rolled as well.
Last word does not condone the use of cocaine or any other drugs. Let me put that out there.
Fuck that.
And rolled also. Rolled is a podcast.
Oh, rolled. We actually fuck with y'all a lot.
Literally, rolled is a podcast brand. So that'd be good. But I think it's been a good episode, y'all.
It's been a great episode.
Happy 1 year anniversary, bro.
Not for real.
Happy birthday, y'all.
You know what? Come on. Right. Bring it in, y'all.
FML.
What does that mean?
Fuck my life.
Oh, okay.
You never seen 13 Reasons Why?
Yeah. Oh, Lord. Let's end this video before it gets any darker. It's your boy Cartier J, and I've had the last word.
Keep buying condoms. Stay out the bathwater.